Hi, everybody. I found some more information about the blood red moon that occurred this month on the 15th. I found these photos from different places in the world where the blood moon was seen. The title of this, I got this off of Yahoo News, and the title of this is Volcano Ash Turns Asian Eclipse Blood Red, and it says that the Asian and African night owls were treated to a lunar eclipse in the ash in the atmosphere for a Chilean volcano turned it blood red for some viewers. And so we just take note of that about the volcanoes erupting also during this time. So there's been some earth activity going on. Okay, here's our first image of the red moon. This is the moon turned red during a total lunar eclipse of the moon seen in Nairobi, Kenya on June 15, 2011. And that a lot of people were out that night looking up at the lunar eclipse and the ash in the atmosphere from the Chilean volcano turned it a blood red for some viewers. And astronomical calculations confirmed that it would be one of the two largest total lunar eclipses of the century, a total of 85 total lunar eclipses, according to scientists, and will be taking place this century, of which the longest total lunar eclipse will occur on July 27, 2018. Okay, and here's another one of the moon. This was seen in Manila, the Philippines, before dawn Thursday, June 16, 2011. The total lunar eclipse was also visible in most parts of Asia. And as you can see, that the Earth cast a shadow on the moon. And here, and okay, the next one. Okay, what we see here is the shadow of the Earth falls on the moon during a total eclipse in Malaga, in southern Spain, late June 15, 2011. And the picture is a long exposure. It shows the long exposure of the moon. Very interesting. These are a combination photo that shows the moon as it undergoes the total lunar eclipse as seen from Jerusalem on June 15, 2011. Okay, this is a partial lunar eclipse seen over the skies of Belgrade on June 15, 2011. Okay, and again, we have a partially eclipsed moon that rises on the sky over Belgrade and Serbia on Wednesday, June 15, 2011. The total lunar eclipse was visible throughout most parts of Europe on Wednesday evening. This is a man that walks by the partial lunar eclipse moon rises on the sky over Belgrade and Serbia. On June 15th, the total lunar eclipse was visible throughout the Europe that day. The moon turns red during a total lunar eclipse, as seen as Skopje. I have a problem pronouncing it. S K O P J E. That's in Macedonia, and that's in Europe. That was seen on Wednesday, June 15th, 2011. Okay, and you see these lights. This is lights of an aircraft that was pictured as the shadow of the Earth fell on the moon during a total eclipse in Malaga, southern Spain. Okay, this is a six-picture combo. The Earth cast its shadow over the moon in a total a lunar eclipse. Okay, and this is a five-picture series of various stages of the total lunar eclipse over Belgrade and Serbia between 20:30. This is military time on 21:30. Local time on Wednesday, June the 15th. So that would be between what? Between eight in at night to 10 at night, if I'm not mistaken. I would think of the military time, trying to convert it to military time. Anyway, okay, and here's the lunar eclipse, the scene is the over the Adamonium in Brussels, Germany, on Thursday, June the 16th. And you see that above right there. The Earth casts a shadow over the moon during the total eclipse behind the Parthenon of the Freedom sculpture, featuring a torch at Three Power Square in downtown Brazil, Brasilia, Brazil, on June the 15th. Okay, and this shadow is falls on the total moon eclipse as seen as in Brasilia. A shadow falls on the moon during a partial lunar eclipse at the Vitorino Monument on Piazza Venezia, and it's in Rome. Excuse my pronunciation of these names. And that was on June the 15th. Okay, the moon is seen behind the wall of the Damascus Gate in Jerusalem, right here in the center. And the old, see, it says it was in the Jerusalem, the old city, during a total eclipse on June the 15th. And the residents here look at the moon and partial lunar eclipse under the Roman pillars of the Temple of Hercules in Amman, Amman, June the 15th. Okay, is this this is trying to tell something with all these? I don't know. It's just interesting. That's all I can say. Okay, now this was very interesting. This was the moon that was seen behind the wall of the Damascus Gate in Jerusalem in the Old City during a total lunar eclipse, June the 15th. Okay, now the image projected on the wall is part of Jerusalem's Festival of Lights. Okay? And that's interesting imagery. Let's see the moon. There's the moon there. And that's an interesting imagery there. I mean, look at the little green guy right here. I mean, do they worship leprechauns? Strange things. That's all I can say. Very strange. Okay, and there's a partial lunar eclipse in the village of Zetun, which is in Malta. It's above the church, the feast of St. Catherine's in South Malta. The lights are very pretty. The residents here seen a partial eclipse under the Roman pillars of the Temple of Hercules in Amman here. You can see the people there looking at the moon. And the moon is seen behind an illuminated cross of a, pardon me for saying this, Arios Nikolaos Church during a lunar eclipse over Nicosia. This is in Cyprus on Wednesday, June the 15th. You can barely see it here. It's mostly overshadowed and also very interesting pictures. Okay, this is the last one. It says a lunar eclipse is in progress of Harare, Zimbabwe, on Wednesday, June 15th, 2011. This is the total lunar eclipse occurred in some parts of Africa, Asia, the Middle East, and Western Australia. And the 100-minute period of totality is said to be the longest since 2000, according to astronomers. Okay, well, that was all my picture show right now. I hope you found this some interest in this and what you could get out of it. I just thought I'd bring it to you. I was just adding this on for historical purposes and to add with my other videos I had about the blood red moon. And that's it. So y'all take care. God bless y'all. Jesus loves you. And I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.